Welcome to the Great Exodus series. My name is Michael, and I am the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today, on Pentecost, on the 9th of June, I would like to talk to you about the harvest. Is it not written in the Bible that the fields are white and ripe for harvest? And Jesus has told us, there are plenty of fields, but only few harvest workers. So now he is calling you forth. As he called forth his own disciples, his own apostles at Pentecost, by pouring out the Holy Spirit onto them, so that they could go into the nations and bring in the harvest, his harvest. Now we are standing at the time, just before the escape of the bride, and the first believers will be taken to the third heaven. Now is the time for the rest, for the remnant that will remain. Do not fear if you remain. Not everybody can go in the escape of the bride. Not everybody is so perfect. So now is the time for the remnant who will remain to take up the cross and to go into the nation and to gather the harvest, to look for the lost sheep, to rescue the multitude in white, to take the pearls from the dragon, to snatch the small kittens from the python, so that they are not being eaten, to rescue all the people who have only a little understanding, not yet fully, they are not weaned of the milk yet. They cannot eat the meat yet, but we have to rescue them, take them out of the world and out of Babylon, into the sacred assemblies of Yahweh, the societies of the Rose, where they will gather together in love, unity and support. So please join me. Be a harvest worker for the Lord. Walk as the apostle did. What did the apostles do? At this time, after the Lake of Tiberias and after Pentecost, they went into the nation and they did what? They did the same works that Jesus also did. They walked as he did, they talked as he did, they looked through his eyes, and they brought many to righteousness. And that's exactly what you are also called for. Read Daniel 12:3. When Michael will stand up, then afterwards, it is your work as a harvest worker now to bring as many people to righteousness as possible. Sorry. Follow me. Follow me on the path to Mount Zion and on our walk through the wilderness to Mount Zion in the great Exodus, the same pattern as the first Exodus. We will gather all the people in the nations together in true balance and harmony into sacred assemblies that will be protected by Yahweh. They will be placed under his wings and be protected against any calamity that will come now with the judgments. You can be part of it, but you have to step out. Step through that open door that is right in front of your face, onto the new path, the path to Mount Zion. And then we can shout in a big chorus to Satan and to his minions. We can shout, let us go. Well, Yahweh will tune in with, let my people go. It is a similar pattern to the first Exodus. And of course, we will not go empty-handed, as it is written in Daniel 12:3, that this is the time to bring in the righteous. What is written for the wealth transfer? The wealth of the sinners are stored up for the righteous. So now, if this is the time to bring many people to righteousness, if this is the time to bring many people to righteousness, then this also must be the time of the wealth transfer. I have a very clear idea of how it will happen. But this is nothing that I will pronounce now here in public. But the funds will be available, and then we will be able to reach all the nations everywhere, every place, every layer of the dragon we will reach. And we will snatch all the pearls from him. We will rescue all the kittens from the python. We will take the snake by the head and rescue the multitude in white and bring the multitude to Mount Zion. For the glory of the Father and his only begotten Son, Yeshua HaMashiach, our Lord and Savior. And we will not walk in discussing and bickering and backstabbing. No, we will walk in love, unity and support for all to see. And people will ask, who are these people? Why are they so content? Why are they so happy? And then they want to join you or us in our societies of the Rose. And then we will say, you are welcome. Come as you are. Even if you are the great sinner, you will be washed clean in the blood of the Lamb on the way to Mount Zion. Everything is written. Read the book of Revelation, all it there. So I'm calling you forth to the mountain. Walk with us and gather in the harvest. Become a harvest worker. This is the time now to snatch the pearls from the dragon. Be part of it. Watch all our videos. Join Triple Grace, the website. The links are in the description box below. Help us to send our missions into the world. Now we have a mission to Cambodia. Assist us, support us. If you can, even financially, make donations. Assist us with all what you can so that we can fulfill God's plan of rescue, the great Exodus, and gather in the kittens, gather in the harvest, gather in the multitudes. Please be part of it. Alone I cannot do it. You have to walk with me. And if you have questions, you can send them to me at triplegrace55@gmail.com. Ask your questions. Ask, where have you come from? Why have you appeared suddenly? Nobody knows Michael. Yes, I understand that. But was it not like that always? Now is the time to move out. Now is the time to go forward. And the Lord is calling you out to do action now, not to remain seated, not to stay in a false grace philosophy. That everything is okay and you just have to wait. That is not the case. Many people will be surprised. Please understand one thing, and one thing for all, is that you were saved by faith through grace alone, and you will never work for your salvation. But after you are saved, if your heart is not yearning to do the work of the Lord and do that in public and bring it into the nations, then I must say I'm sorry, but then you are not saved. Because this yearning of your heart and your soul, it's crying forth, want to burst open and want to explain to everybody and want to show it and to gather the people in. This is part of salvation. Jesus never stopped to do anything. He never stopped his work. He continued every day. He healed the sick. He lifted up the needy. He taught the unawares. He went to the sinners, and he was seeking the lost sheep every day. So do not sit in your church benches, but step out. Step into the open and let your light shine onto these nations, onto the earth, for all to see. I love you all so dearly, and I hope that you walk with me that path towards Mount Zion. Come and join me. You are part of the harvest. Come, walk with us to Mount Zion, the dwelling place of the Father. Be raptured in that great harvest, the harvest of the ages, into paradise, to be with him and his only begotten Son, Yeshua HaMashiach, forever and ever. I thank you that you're here with me. Please, if you feel guided by the Holy Spirit, to send us donations, to help us financially, so that we can establish more sacred assemblies in the nations, that we can reach more people, especially the smaller ones in the faith, then please use the links in the description box below. Help us to bring it forth. In Jesus' name I pray. May God bless you and your family abundantly. My name is Michael, and I will see you again tomorrow. Maranatha.